The one trade that triggered for a day trade today, a today trade, where ideally I get a setup and a fill before 10:05 to 10:35, was the ES. Now, if I'm looking at the ES during that time of day, it opens up a couple possibilities on the futures side, too. ES futures and the MES. So I could look at ES, which is the mini. We could look at the MES. And actually, you can even look at ES options. Really, there's three different ways just to take advantage of the futures setup. Now, what was the setup? Really simple. First off, we started the day and spent most of the early part of the session above the previous session close, the PSC. Now, I kind of endearingly call this the line in the sand. And what that means is this thing is a level that represents the 4 p.m. cash close from the previous session, hence previous session close. All right. It's a level that I've watched for many, many years. And it's a really cool sentiment line, hence line in the sand. All right. So we're above that. Then we sunk down right in here. We sunk down right in here, specifically at the 10:25 candle. During the 10:25 a.m. Eastern candle, we sunk down into the hourly price movement range, which was just marginally above the previous session close, and that triggered the trade. It's really important to know what triggers the trade, what price that is, what is the environment, bullish momentum, neutral trend, and that's a long call. It's certainly not a long put, right? So it's a long call setup. And you can see here, November 22, 593 or 592 call. When we are 0 days to options on the SPY, I will sometimes opt to be a little bit deeper in the money. But before I switch to the SPY chart, please note every single decision about whether or not I wanted to trade the S&P and where I wanted to trade the S&P is really made off the 23-hour version of the S&P, which is the ES futures. Plenty of attention, plenty of open interest, plenty of volume, 23 hours a day. Now, the trade on the SPY is the perfect way for any trader to start to get acclimated to trading the S&P. It's a slower moving, less expensive alternative to what else we'll discuss here as I described this early morning day trade. I took it in two ways. I did not take the futures variety, although you can see that was perfectly valid. SPY 592 calls is what I opted for. So when this candle happened right in here, that's the SPY. That's the 592 call. And I paid $2.10 per contract for those calls. The first time we scaled out at 356, I believe. 356. So that was a neat, decent little move that we had moving higher. And here's a cool thing, and keep this in mind as I go through the other two examples of the S&P. This candle not only hit our price trigger, but it went below it. So this is what we would call heat or unrealized loss. In the case of the S&P, that was 7 cents per contract. So what I bought at 210, that bid eventually dropped. I think the lowest trade I saw was 203. So 7 cents unrealized loss, very momentarily, but that was the unrealized loss per contract. Let me go back to the ES though, because we have to talk about unrealized loss. This notion that we only think about profits, we only think about, you know, what we were able to scale out at, has to be balanced by how much did we risk along the way? Because that could potentially and eventually be the loss. In the case of the ES, here's the trigger, here's the low. That was $275 per ES contract. So that was the negative, it was the unrealized loss. That was the heat that we took until finally it reached its target. And not a bad little move, right? As you go from the edge of the daily price movement range, roughly 59.68, to the other edge of the hourly price movement range to 59.86 at $50 a contract. Okay. Lastly, and this is the one that I think a lot of people are really interested in, but to me it's no more special, it's really no different than any of the other two trades that we just talked about. SPX. When the ES comes down into that zone that we talked about. SPY is valid, SPX is valid, XSP is valid, as is frankly the MES Micro S&P as well. So all those are being watched as a singular setup off the 23-hour version of the S&P, the ES futures. So here, once again, at 1025, here's the SPX, sunk down into that range. And in the case of the SPX, this is one of the rare exceptions where I do go out of the money as opposed to at or in from the standpoint of a budget. In other words, playing an at the money SPX is an expensive proposition. So we think about budget and we actually look at an out of the money strike. We paid $3.70 for that. So the SPY was $2.10. That thing went to $3.56. Now this is why folks do like SPX, because we paid $3.70 for this. By the way, what was the unrealized loss per contract? How much heat did we take? It was 40 cents per contract. So please, as you're making your way into the S&P trading life, which is very cool, it doesn't mean there's going to be an S&P trade every day. It just means that we're looking for a trade on ES, and then lots of opportunities will present themselves. But unless you're calibrated to more volatility, look at the difference of unrealized loss of 7 cents versus 40. Now, some folks might say, Rog, 40 cents, if that option you bought dropped to 330, and it did, that's not going to stop me out. And you're right, not going to stop me out either. Ultimately, this thing hit, I wrote down 770. I know it hit 5 something. I think it was 550. And then ultimately it hit 770 before it chopped right back down. All right. That was the first trade of the morning. S&P, those are three ways that I look at it in terms of a choose your own adventure, with ES being the touchstone for every version of the S&P that we could watch. There's nothing magical about any one of them, except for the fact that as long as you understand the initial margin, the fees, the commission, the volatility, right, involved, right, you can choose the one that's right for you. Hey traders, Raghee from Simpler Trading. Thank you so much for watching this video. Be sure to leave a like and a comment below. And remember, subscribe and click the bell icon so you'll get notified of the next update. And when you're ready to join me for live trading, be sure to head on over to simplertrading.com. I'll see you in the next update.